Okay, so Adobe Fresco is updated. There are three main things that make it mind-blowingly awesome with this new Apple Pencil. So I'm going to walk you through it in this video right now. Let's go. Okay, so first thing we need to do is go ahead and get our brushes configured. So if we go ahead and click on our brush icon, you'll come down here into library brushes. I am going to be working with my brushes. These are brushes that I use in Photoshop. They're compatible with Adobe Fresco. And I label all of my brushes with tilt and rotation. So let's say, for example, if I come into oils, and right now you'll see I have flat dry rotation activated. Now if I take this brush, okay, and then I come down here to the settings, brush settings, and click right here. If you go down to shape dynamics, and you'll see the angle control, you want to make sure it's set to barrel roll. So this is important. If you bought brushes from me, the Photoshop brushes, when you bring it in, all of the brushes that are set to rotation, you will have to do this because Adobe did not have it where it automatically comes in with the barrel rotation. That may happen in the future, but it's not as of yet. So this is what you're gonna have to do. Once you have the barrel rotation, we can go ahead and come down here and you can see if I spin the rotation and the orientation, you can see this. I'm gonna make this brush bigger, just so you can see this. Okay, and you can see it's pretty fluid. There's no latency and it's straightforward. This next step is mind blowing. If this doesn't get you excited, I don't know what will. Let me show you exactly what it is. Okay, so if you come inside of Fresco, all right, if you wanna eyedrop multicolors, so first, before we do that, if I click and hold with my finger here, it activates just like any other eyedropper. And you'll see that it gives you a single color, okay? So when you're doing something like this and you want it to feel extremely painterly and you wanna have a lot of brush strokes and stridations in it, this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna click on this little icon right here, click, double tap, okay? And so what you wanna do is have it where the blue dot is on the center, okay? The blue dot has to be on the center. Now what you're gonna do is take your finger and hold, and if you look at the magnifying glass, which is the eyedropper, it's grabbing multiple colors. If you pay close attention over here, you'll see that it's showing you multiple colors here, okay? Now watch, as long as this is activated with the blue dot in the center, and I hold my finger down again, okay, let's go right here. You see I can get a gradient for my brush stroke, okay? So you can see it's dark and light on the opposite side, right? Now, when you're ready to paint, right now by default, when the blue dot is in the center, this is gonna be set to eraser, okay? So we wanna paint now. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna go ahead and tap that blue circle, and now it's going to allow you to paint. Now this is where it's amazing. Okay, I'm going to do it over here so you can see it. So if you brush down, you see how there's a little bit darker color on one side and it's lighter on the other side. Now this is the beauty of barrel rotation, okay? When I rotate this to the opposite side, now I have the dark on the other side. And you see all of the stridations in the brush, okay? So when I want to paint, this just makes it super easy for me, okay? So let me go ahead and pull this down, right? And so now, here, let's go ahead and Command-Z some of that out of there. So now with these strokes on here, when I come in here and paint, I want you to see how I'm able to get this very painterly stridations and look. This is how I'm getting a lot of this effect. So let's say, for example, if I come over here and sample that color, hold on, key there, I'm glad that happened. Make sure you go to the blue dot in the center, click and hold. There's the color. You can see the stridations in there. Oh, and it was on eraser, I gotta remember that. Okay. And this gives you just a little bit more painterly strokes if you want that look, which I love, okay? So if you wanna disengage, you just double tap and now you're out. If you click now and hold, it will go back to solid color. Awesome feature. This for me is just like amazing, amazing, amazing. third thing here we want to break down is the haptic, so we're going to take this click, and I want you to see what's happening. I'm going to click this again here, tap, click. All right, so if you look over here on your brush controls, you'll see all of these from that line down, this whole palette right here. When I come over here and click or squeeze, it will now give us our color, size, flow, smoothing, paint inside, on or off, and then we have our brush settings. And this is again where you'll be able to turn on your barrel rotation under shape dynamics right here. Okay, beautiful. Everything about this is just awesome. I'm enjoying this. I'm loving it. It's, you know, what else can I ask for? This is giving me the ability to do paintings that I used to be able to do. Well, I can do in Corel Painter. A lot of people don't use Corel Painter that much anymore, but I think it's still amazing. And all of these features that you're seeing here, like this being able to load multiple colors on brushstroke, that was in Corel Painter probably like 15 years ago, 16 years ago. And it's so weird how something that's so old as a feature, but no one ever really adapted it to any software. But Adobe Fresco is this, the application that is the most like Corel Painter for me. But it has some other things that's just even more powerful than Corel. And now we have this right here on this iPad. So it just has me super excited. I'm gonna go ahead and work on this one and play with this a little bit more, finish it out.